Hello, you're feeling a little nervous today? It's Animals Day. Don't worry, animals are actually way easier than you think they are. There's a few little basic techniques, but you'll soon get the hang of them, and believe it or not, you've actually learnt a lot of them and used a lot of them already. So let's hit the road running and draw our squirrel. Here's a cool trick for you. Watch as I combine the light box and scratch and sketch techniques to save myself heaps of lead. Now let's take a closer look at the squirrel and see what type of techniques we are going to need in order to draw him. Areas like here by his eye look pretty familiar. We've drawn shadings before, right? And areas like this over here also seem to be reasonably shaded. But now look over here on his arm, over there, and over there, and there. And pretty much the rest of his body. To draw that, we're going to use a technique which, believe it or not, you've already done. And that is flicks. In other words, we're going to start from the start of the hair and we're going to flick it towards the inside of the hair. So you draw the line and at the last little piece you flick it. Well, what is important here is to follow the direction of the hair. If you don't get the direction right, you won't get the shape right. So here you see the flicks are going in that direction. Over here the flicks are going in that direction. And even to get this corner right, here the flicks are going more in there. Then they're flattening out straight. And now they're gradually changing direction and going the opposite direction. You see that? So it's really important to get those directions right or your squirrel is going to look flat. Let's get a close-up view of some of those flicks so you can get a feel for what you need to do. I'm going to start at the outside of his arm using an HB pencil. Flick, 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 flick. Now it's quite a fast movement because you want to get that nice flowing feel. Now you'll find as you're drawing, your tip of your pencil, which I'm using a sharp point by the way, the tip of your pencil tends to get blunt and your lines get fuzzier and fuzzier. So to keep it sharp while I'm doing my flicks, I do a few flicks and then I turn my pencil. Do a few more flicks, I turn my pencil, and that way you'll always end up with keeping your point. You're almost sharpening your pencil as you go. Now notice over here, it's dark over there and dark over there, and it gets lighter over here. So I'm going to put lots of short little flicks over here and then a few longer ones to give me that shading over there. And again, I start off with an HB pencil and then eventually I'll come back in over here with a B or a 2B pencil, which will also help me to get the darker lines. Take your time with the drawing. Doesn't matter how long you take to draw it. What does matter is the end result. Notice how I'm gradually changing the direction of my flicks to give me the molding in the arm. These flicks and those flicks must tie up, they form a semicircle. Okay, now we've got the basics, so let's start darkening it up by using a B pencil. So now we're adding that lovely contrast. Notice how real flowing motion I'm using. That's important. If you don't use a nice flowing motion, your flicks tend to be too controlled. You'll also notice that I'm gradually building it up. Not trying to go too dark too quickly, that's really the biggest mistake. I started my drawing by completing the arm first to show you the technique we use. You'll obviously start from top to bottom as normal. When drawing the hair is so short, we use more of a scribble than a flick. The mouth, ear and eye are shaded in as we want maximum detail in this area. Notice how the hairs are all sweeping backwards to meet the neck. Now we can move on to the body. Here we use longer, straighter flicks. Watch how quickly I'm able to do these flicks already. Each downward motion is on the paper, each upward movement, my hand is lifted. With a bit of practice, you can easily complete this drawing in 30 minutes. When drawing the legs, look carefully at the direction of the flicks. Now I want to show you how I curve the tail. Notice how I start with very short curved flicks, then quickly straighten them out. This gives me that sweeping effect. Complete the left-hand side of the tail with long sweeping flicks. Finish off the drawing by scribbling in the background. Wow, who would have thought that flicks and a little bit of shading for detail was all it took to draw such a stunning squirrel. Absolutely amazing. Well, tomorrow we're going to be drawing a horse. That's going to be even more fun. You have a great time drawing your squirrel. I'll see you then.